Hello, and welcome to the Illumina Customer Solutions Lab. I'm Brian.
And I'm David. We're here to give you an unprecedented behind-the-scenes introduction to Illumina's newest innovation in the world of next-generation sequencing, the NovaSeq series of systems. The NovaSeq platform leverages some of Illumina's greatest technological advances in one complete package, utilizing the patent flow cell technology from the HiSeq 3000-4000 platform and combining it with the two-channel chemistry and the simplicity of use demonstrated in our NextSeq platform. What is now available to users is a highly flexible, easy-to-use, yet incredibly powerful instrument capable of sequencing anywhere from 167 billion bases in a single flow cell to upwards of 6 trillion bases in a single run. With this new technology, Illumina can now offer a single solution that covers a wide variety of library types at a very low cost per sample.
That's pretty impressive, David. What I'm most excited about is the simplified workflow required to start the NovaSeq platform, which includes that onboard cluster generation, as well as the fact that the platform has a lot of room to grow. Some of our legacy customers might remember that the HiSeq 2000 released in 2010 boasted an output of 200 gigabases per run. That same platform evolved over time to become that HiSeq X, which now produces over 1.6 terabases per run. Who knows how far we can take the NovaSeq series.
Brian, can you show us some of the features of the system, including both the consumables and the instrument itself, as well as demonstrate what the workflow for a typical run might look like?
Sounds great, David. Not only did the development team combine the pattern flow cell and the two-channel chemistry technology, but they also optimized the workflow by utilizing the cartridge-based reagent delivery system used by the MiniSeq, MySeq, NextSeq systems, making the process of setting up a run easier than ever. We'll start with the cartridges. The first cartridge, which has all of your frozen reagents, will be shipped on dry ice and stored at minus 20 degrees C. The cartridge can be placed in the refrigerator overnight to thaw for a run to be started the next day, or thawed at room temperature water bath for a few hours just before the run. There's an empty well, which is used to place the prepared library tube just before you start the run. Setting up the prepared libraries is very similar and just as easy as with HiSeq instruments. To start, we're going to push the sequence button and then push OK. The flow cell door is going to open, and I've already loaded the library tube into the cartridge. My next step is to open the door, open the compartment for the reagents, and then slide the tray open. I'm then going to put the reagent cartridge into the tray. The second frozen cartridge is the Sps reagents. This cartridge is shipped on dry ice and stored at minus 20 degrees. And for thawing, you can follow the same procedure as with your reagent cartridge. You don't have to load a sample in here, so you would just load this into the tray. You then close the tray, and then close the door. The third cartridge contains your Sps buffers, which are shipped and stored at room temperature. This eliminates the need to acquire additional refrigeration, which I really appreciate as a former lab manager. There's no steps needed to prepare the buffer cartridge, and it's ready to use as is. I'm now going to open the tray, place in the reagent buffer cartridge, and close the door. Close the door, and if I were going to start a run on the other side, I would repeat the process here. And close the door. The last, and quite possibly most interesting consumable, is the flow cell. The NovaSeq series is a comfortable fit for most researchers looking for a large number of bases sequenced over a relatively short period of time. The pattern flow cells are a bit larger than even the NextSeq flow cell, packing a ton of clusters between these two pieces of glass. The reagent cartridge, buffer cartridge, library tube, and flow cell all contain a unique radio frequency identification, or RFID chip, making tracking of consumables automatic. There's no longer a need to use a barcode scanner for the information to be entered into the run setup screen. Now let's take a look at that sequencer. The first feature that you might notice is that it's only 2 feet, 2.5 feet by 3 feet. The footprint is smaller than a HiSeq. There's no need to give up valuable bench space for the NovaSeq platform or its computational components. The self-contained design incorporates everything from the reagent cartridge and waste bottle compartments to waste bottle storage and onboard server for primary analysis. The NovaSeq series even has built-in casters in case a field service engineer ever has to relocate your instrument. To set up a run, the prepared and denatured libraries was pipetted into that library tube, which we then put into the cartridge. Now here on the screen, we'll have to first load the flow cell and then close the flow cell door. With the intuitive user interface, starting a run is stress-free. It's here where you're going to notice the similarities to previous workflows on Illumina's other sequencers, from preparing samples for clustering, then creating a sample sheet in Illumina Experiment Manager, and uploading it to the instrument. The NovaSeq series will be an easy transition for any customer. Some new additions introduced into the NovaSeq workflow, like the run setup file if you're using a LIMS system, updates to the loading concentration for clustering, and faster run times for the high-throughput sequencer. You can expect to load your library at 200 to 300 picomole, which is a bit more than that library than on a high-seq. What is most impressive is that the onboard cluster generation with the runtime for an S2 flow cell from start to finish for a 2x150 run will be 40 hours, 29 hours for a 2x100, and as little as 19 hours for a 2x50. You can run a massive amount of samples in a relatively short period of time, enabling rapid sequencing and data output with a minimal effort from the user. I'm now going to tell the system that I've emptied out the waste trays, and I'm going to push the run setup button. Once you've entered all the instructions for the sequencer, you push review. This may look very familiar from one of our other sequencers. After you reviewed your run, press the pre-run checks button. The instrument will go through a series of pre-run checks, which are designed to diagnose potential problems before the run even starts. One really cool feature is the ability to run different modes at the same time. For example, if you want to run a whole genome sequencing with an S3 flow cell on side A, and a whole exome sequencing with an S2 flow cell on side B, the NovaSeq platform can accommodate it. It's also possible to simultaneously use the instrument in online mode on one side, stream your data to base-based sequence hub, and in local mode on the other side, to stream data to the local server. And our team here at Illumina can always assist with custom computation and storage solutions with genomics IT services. Once your run setup is finished and goes through that series of pre-run checks, we can push the sequence button. You're now on your way to massive amounts of sequence bases. A big advantage to using one of Illumina's sequencers is the capability of streaming and analyzing data on base-based sequence hub. If you don't have a base-based sequence hub account, you can sign up for one on the Illumina website by clicking the My Illumina tab at the top right of the screen. Once you have an account, it's possible to monitor ongoing runs on any of our sequencers, analyzing data using one of the many apps available in the App Store, access public data from previous runs, or further analyze data using the Illumina correlation engine. Laboratories frequently ask about customized bioinformatics support, including custom app development, and Illumina professionals are happy to work with you to manage your data needs. To monitor an ongoing run, log into Base-Based Sequence Hub, click the Runs tab at the top of the screen. You will see a list of all your current and previous runs to review the metrics. This is where you can see metrics like cluster density, clusters passing filter percentages, and your Q30 metrics. For the NovaSeq series, a 65 to 75% passing filter rate is a successful run at the optimal cluster density. You'll also notice that the clustering process will have a wider window for optimal clustering when it comes to loading concentration. This is just another way that Illumina has made it easier to get to high-quality sequencing data. When your run is finished, the NovaSeq platform will automatically initiate a post-run wash, which will prolong the life of your instrument as well as help you maintain high-quality sequencing data. For those customers that can further benefit from instrument compliance services, for instance, installation qualification, operational qualification, and performance qualification services, Illumina can help to ensure quality guidelines are met. Analysis on Base-Based Sequence Hub is also an intuitive process. In this example, I'll walk you through a typical whole genome analysis. Under the Apps tab at the top of the screen in Base-Based Sequence Hub, click on Resequencing on the right-hand side. Choose the Whole Genome Sequencing app. All of the app information and references are located on the application landing page. To choose this app, click Launch. On the next screen, choose your project. Next, select your sample FASTQ files. You also have the option of starting from BAM files. After that, choose the reference genome you would like to align your samples with. The application will then process your data, sending you an email notification when it's finished. The outputs are your VCF file, which contains your sample's variants as well as associated metrics like coverage and alignment. We're happy to offer you a chance to experience this sequencer's capabilities with your samples firsthand through our proof of concept offering. David?
Thanks, Brian. This is a really nice description of what the workflow on the NovaSeq series looks like, and how easy it can be. The NovaSeq series is built from the ground up to accelerate your research, giving you the flexibility and scalability to complete projects faster and more economically than ever before across a broad range of applications.